We turn now to the hard-hit Western Mass communities along the Connecticut border. Western Mass News reporter Sarah Grinnelli is live in East Longmeadow with a look at the damage left behind. Sarah?
Jordan, nearly 5,000 people, more than 4,000 people, nearly 5,000 are almost without power tonight. As you can see, it is pitch black here. This is North Main Street that is blocked off because earlier when we drove down this road, power lines were actually dangling in the road. Now, earlier today, we were also in Agawam where we spoke with one woman who describes the terrifying moment a tree came crashing on her home.
Huge crash and a big bang.
People are now picking up the pieces after Tropical Storm Isaias barreled across the Connecticut border into Western Mass with destructive winds and heavy rain.
My son was sitting on the couch and all of a sudden we heard a big smash and a big thug and we all came running and it was the tree.
Western Mass News found this damage of a house on River Road in Agawam. The owner did not want to go on camera but said they now have to fix the big gaping hole where the window used to be. A little further down the same road, a tree crashed on top of power lines. And in neighboring Southwick, the whipping winds sent tree branches crashing down on top of a store.
A lot of the challenge is just handling storm damage in general. It's high risk.
Owner of ArborTech Tree Service, Randy Sample, says several people have already called him about removing trees from their yards and on top of their homes.
Our objective even with storm damage is to minimize impact to the property or more impact to the home. So we try to utilize all the equipment we have, you know, whether it's a crane or boom-assisted trucks.
Again, nearly 5,000 people here in East Longmeadow in the dark tonight, and it's going to take quite some time to restore power. Live in East Longmeadow, I'm Sarah Grinnelli for Western Mass News.